Hello guys, this is Chip Shui from Warmane, Icecrown Realm, and today I'm gonna show you how to farm heavy junk boxes for your insane title. As you can see, we are inside Blackrock Spire dungeon, which is divided by two wings. Upper Blackrock Spire, which is on the left side, and lower Blackrock Spire, which is on the right side. And we are going to run lower Blackrock Spire for this grind. Before we start, I have some tips for you, and one of them is related to loot window. So go to mineral phase, controls, and check the last two boxes over here. The first one, open the loot window at your mouse, it's obviously, and the second one, When you click a mob, for example a dead mob, and want to loot, when you right click the mob, it will automatically loot everything, and this applies to pickpocket too. So it will save you a lot of time. The second tip is about macros, related to macros, and I have three of them. The first one is mouse over, pickpocket macro. The second and the third one are for a single and multi-target, and I will show you in a minute. So I'm gonna use mouse over macro just so you can see, guys. Get close to a target, mouse over, use the macro. Mouse over, oh, too far away. Mouse over is the macro. Mouse over, mouse over. This is the first one. The second one, it's tricky. It's kind of messy. I'll show you why. Let me get down here, find the group. Sap, okay. So this one, we'll switch between targets and loot them. Go in middle of them and just spam the macro. See? Fast. Why I don't like that macro? It's because, for example, I'm here, I want to use the macro on this group. Let's say I'm facing those guys upstairs here. If I use this macro, it will switch between targets, but will also target the mobs that are far away from me. So this is kind of messy. So that's why I'm using the single target one, which will only target the closest mob in front of me. So if I'm facing this mob right here, it will target and pickpocket, like that. If I move towards this one, it will target this one and loot him. And this is better for me, you know, for my needs. It's faster, you just run. See? Easy peasy. I also use subspec, obviously, for shadow step. Shadow step comes handy when it comes to this grind. And I will show you why. Oh, I always forget to pickpocket this bitch. I always forget he's after the corner. Sap. Sap this one so you can pass through him to the next mob, and then move on. So after you pickpocket all the mobs up here, you have to go down there, but you have to go the way you came, and this is where a shadow step comes handy. You target that guy right there and shadow step. sometimes they see you, so you have to vanish. So yeah, shadow step is also handy when you finish the run and try to come back to the entrance, because it's a fucking long way, you know. You go there, go down there, enter, get up, and so on, get up here, and then in the end you go up there where's the final boss. That's the entrance where the boss is, the last boss. So I'll try to get to the last boss as fast as I can, and I'll come back to you guys with more tips. See you in a minute. Okay guys, so I'm back. I managed to get to the last boss, and I have like 82 boxes so far. I was lucky with RNG. We'll see how many boxes I'll get until the end. So now that we finished the run, we have to get back. And the fastest way to get back, if you are engineering like I am, there's an enchant with parachute. Everyone knows about that. So from here, you are going to use rocket boots and parachute and land down there. And from there, you are away from the entrance, like, I don't know, maybe 10 seconds away from the entrance. But in case you don't have the parachute, you don't have the enchant, like I don't, because my enchant, my cloak with enchant is in the bank. I didn't pick it for this grind, but I'm fine. So in this case, you can just jump down there and use shadow step to this guy, pickpocket him again. So yeah, if you don't have full bags, you can always go back to the entrance and start pickpocketing again, because the pockets of the mobs will refill after 10 minutes, I think. That's a cooldown. So you don't have to get outside and reset the dungeon and redo all the thing. You just go back at the entrance and start pickpocketing again until you get full bags. And then use your mailbox to send the boxes to your alts or customers, in case you guys are grinding boxes to sell them, because many people do, and so I did. And they are selling for about between 25 and 50 gold each. It depends. You can always negotiate. Some people are willing to pay less, some are willing to pay more, you know, in order to get their title. So yeah, for example, I have like 5 chars outside the dungeon. I brought them here. They all have engineering so I can use the mailbox. And I send junk boxes to my olds or customers. Because the mailbox has 2-hour cooldown. If you have like 5 of them, it's fine. You'll never have to wait for the cooldown. You can also create a new guild, buy all the tabs, and store the boxes in the guild bank. And when you have a customer, you can create a you can create drinks. Hold on. You create ranks and give them permission. For example, you invite someone in guild, a potential customer. You he will be initiate, right? So he doesn't have many rights. And you can give him rights for this rank to view all the tabs, you know? Just so he makes sure that you have the junk boxes he needs, right? And after he pays, you give him officer rank, so he can withdraw all the junk boxes from all tabs. You know, he can take his time, get all of them, and then he can leave the guild. That's another tip. I hope you enjoyed the video, guys. Good luck with farming, and for those who are lazy asses, rich bitches that wants to get those boxes, but they can't be ours to farm them, you can always whisper me in game, or send me an email in game, and I can farm a lot of them for you. So yeah, good luck, guys, and have fun.